गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. आई एम प्रोफेसर श्रद्धा शेके फ्रॉम के वाघ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग नासिक. वेलकम टू अवर लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन द कोर्स डिजिटल सर्किट्स. इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट्स. ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मल्टीप्लेक्सर्स, मल्टीप्लेक्सर ट्रीज and use of multiplexers in combinational logic design. What is a multiplexer? Multiplexing means transmitting a large number of information units over a smaller number of channel or lines. As shown in this diagram, there are four input lines and one output line. The data present on the four input lines is transmitted over the one output line, but it is controlled by the control bits, that is select lines S1 and S0 in this case. So based on the values of select line, data present on every input line is transmitted over the output. There is an animated video taken from the YouTube which explains the working of the multiplexer. So this is basically a 4:1 multiplexer. So first number 4 indicates the input lines. As you can observe, 4 input lines are present, and let us say the data is present at the every input line and one output line is present. The input is selected by that rotating switch, and we can call it as a select switch, and its operation based on the data bits S1 and S2. Let us play this video. Initially, select is switch is at 00, that is the first input line is selected. Observe here. Now second input is selected and the select switch is 10. Select bits are 10 and the output is EEE, that is the data present on the second input line. You can see based on the values of select bits S1 and S0, each and every input line is selected. So 00, 1, input 1, 0, 1, yes, and 1, 1. So multiplexer is a data selector. Let us talk about 2:1 MUX. So first number, that is 2, indicates number of input lines, and 1 is nothing but number of output lines. There are select lines present for a MUX in order to select the input lines. The formula of finding out the select line number is 2:2 select lines is equal to number of inputs. So here I am having 2 input lines, so 2:1 is equals to 2, that's why select lines are 1. So in this case, for a 2:1 MUX, there is only one select line. So if select line is 0, first data is selected, that means W0, as shown in this diagram, a truth table. If select line is 1, the second input line is selected, that is W1. So W0 and W1 means actually the data. Data present on the input line W0 is appeared at the output F. The third diagram indicates SOP, that is sum of product implementation of the 2:1 multiplexer. There are two alternative forms of representing the truth table. You will observe the two input lines are named as D0 and D1 in this diagram, and the output line is there. As per our discussion, if S is 0, that is select line is 0, then D0 input is selected. And if select line is 1, then D1 input is selected. So we can write the expression for the output as S dash D0 plus S D1, which is a soft form, and its implementation also we have seen on the previous slide. Now let us observe the second truth table. This is the alternative forms or the alternative way you can represent the truth table of 2s to 1 mux. Now observe select line S. If you observe carefully, S can have only two values. 4 times it is written as 0 and then 1. But actually the value of S is 0 or it can be 1. Now, as per our discussion, whenever S is 0, D0 is selected. So, you will observe the third column in the second truth table is D0. So, what is meaning of D0? D0 is nothing but the data present on the input line D0. So, if you observe carefully, whenever select line is 0, output is same as that of D0. Right? So, whenever D0 is 0, output is also 0. And whenever D0 is 1, output is also 1. When select line is 1, output is same as that of D1. In this third truth table, when select line is 1, you will observe the second column is for D1. So, output is same as that of D1 in that case. Multiplexer analogy. So, we know for a railway track, there are various railway tracks are present, and the railways from different railway tracks as shown in this diagram, that is I0, I1, I2 and I3, can travel on only one railway track, that is D. So this I0, I1, I2, I3 you can compare with D0, D1, D2, D3 in this diagram. An output line is nothing but D, railway track D as shown in this diagram. But which railway will travel on the output line, that is decided by control lever, or which track, input track should be connected to the output track, that is decided by control lever, which is nothing but the select lines. For a 4s to 1 mux, there will be 4 input lines, 1 output line, and select lines will be, our formula is 2s to select line is equal to number of input lines. So 2s to dash dash is equals to 4. So dash dash is nothing but 2. That means select lines are 2. You will observe here we are referring S1 as most significant bit. That is S1, S0 indicated here are select lines. And 4 input lines D0, D1, D2, D3 and 1 output line is there. So, this is the 4s to 1 mux. So, based on the 4 conditions of S1 and S0, that is 0, 0, D0 is selected, 0, 1, D1 is selected and so on. Observe carefully, while implementing the multiplexers, for the inputs we require AND gates. For the select line, we require inverters, and at the output, you are using OR gate. This is the Boolean expressions for the multiplexers for the 2s to 1 mux, S dash D0 plus SD1, and this is how we can represent for any general multiplexers. Gate level implementation of the multiplexer is shown over here. If you use the positive logic, you are using AND OR structure, and as shown here in the negative logic, the NAND NAND structure is represented. Multiplexer trees, that means cascading or expanding the multiplexers. Large multiplexers can be made by cascading the smaller ones. That means if I have to construct the 8s to 1 mux, 8:1 multiplexer can be implemented by using 4:1 multiplexer. As we know, 8:1 MUX is having 8 input lines and 1 output line. 4:1 MUX is having 4 input lines and 1 output line. So in that case, we require 2 4:1 multiplexers as shown in the first diagram. The two outputs of the 4:1 MUX can be connected to the next 2:1 MUX in order to select final output. So this is how the 8 inputs for 8:1 MUX, you will get the 1 output. But what about the select lines? For 8:1 MUX, there are 3 select lines, and for 4:1 MUX, there are 2 select lines. So most significant bit of the 3 select lines, that is S2, S1, S0, the S2 is connected to the 2:1 MUX. You can observe in this diagram, and S1 and S0 are connected to the 4:1 multiplexers. So whenever S2, which is the most significant bit, is 0, if you try to write down the truth table, then in that case, whenever S2 is 0, as per the operation of the 2:1 MUX, its first input should be selected, and the first input is connected to the output of first 4:1 MUX. That means whenever S2 is 0, first multiplexer is selected, and whenever S2 is 1, the second one is selected, and the data inputs D0 to D3 will be selected based on the values of S1 and S0. The 8:1 MUX can also be implemented by using 2:1 MUX. So, in the second diagram we can observe, we require 4 2:1 multiplexer for that. And the 4 outputs of these multiplexers are connected to the next 4:1 MUX, and one output is obtained. In this case also, the most significant select lines, that is S2, is S2 and S1 are connected at the 4:1 MUX. If S2 and S1 are 0, 0, then its first input, that is the output of the first 2:1 MUX, is selected. But data D0 and D1 is selected from S0. So if S0 is 0, D0 will be selected, and the based on the values of S2 and S1, it is transmitted at the output. So this is how you can design a multiplexer tree. IC74153 is a dual 4:1 multiplexer. So if you use this IC, we are able to implement 1 8:1 MUX. But as we have observed in the previous slide, here if you observe the first diagram, the output of 2 4:1 MUX you have connected to the 1 2:1 MUX. Instead of that, you can connect one OR gate over there, but the select line S2 is obtained by connecting the enable bits of these two multiplexers as shown in this diagram. In this case, enable is active low, and enable bit of the first multiplexer is connected to S2, and its complement, that is after the inversion, is given to the EB, that is enable bit of second multiplexer. This is the circuit which we have to implement during the practicals. We can also implement 16:1 MUX using the 8:1 MUX as shown in this diagram. We require 2 8:1 MUX for that. 16:1 MUX can also be implemented by using 4:1 MUX as shown in this diagram. We can implement 16 as to 1 mux by using 4 as to 1 mux, we will get 4 output lines, and in order to obtain the only one output line, we again connect one more 4 as to 1 mux. Most significant 2 bits of the select line are connected to the 5th 4 as to 1 mux as shown in this diagram. Third is, next topic is use of the multiplexers in the combinational circuit designing. The application of the multiplexer is that we can use this in order to implement the combinational circuit. As shown in this diagram, a 3 input function is given, that is f of ABC is equals to summation 1257. So which is basically a soft form. We have to implement this by using 8 as to 1 multiplexer. As we know that in SOP, your output should be 1 for the given mean terms. So what we will do, we will take one 8 as to 1 mux, 8 inputs of this, the numbers which are given in the above expression are connected, those inputs are connected to the logic 1. And the remaining input should be connected to the ground. The most significant bit is A in the given equation, which is to be connected to the most significant select line, which is S2, S1 and S0. So based on the values of select lines, particular input will be selected. And if you observe, the select line is 0, 0, 0, input D0 is selected, which is connected to the logic 0 in this diagram, and the output will be 0. If you connect select line as 0, 0, 1, then input 1 will be selected, which is connected to the logic 1 in this diagram, and the output will be. The other way of implementing the combinational circuit is by using the folding technique. In this case, if we want to implement this expression using 8 as to 1 mux, what we will do? The 8 as to 1 mux is having 8 input lines starting from D0 to D7. The variable A is 0 and variable A can be 1, which is the most significant bit. So the number which are given in the given expression are written in this table. The terms which are present are either encircled. So in this case, the red color is used to represent the numbers which are given in the above expression. So you will observe, if you observe vertically D0, observe the red colors, that is 0, which corresponds to value of A as 0. So that's why in the third row below, fourth row below the D0, I have written as A dash. If both the terms are present, observe the D1, that is 1 and 9 both are present in the given expression, the input D1 should be connected to VCC. D2, only 10 is present in the given expression, that's why D2 is connected to A. D3, it should be connected to VCC. Instead of ground, connected to the VCC because both the terms are present. D4, it should be connected to A dash, and so on. So take one 8 as to 1 mux and connect these D0 to A dash, D1 to VCC, D2 to A, and so on. And then the select lines S2, S1, S0 is connected to B, C and D inputs. And if you give the inputs, then what to test? While testing the circuit, the output should be 1 for the numbers which are given in the question. That means output should be 1 for 0, it should be 1 for 1, 10, 11 and 13. This is the implementation of the previous circuit by using IC 74153. we have to implement this during the practicals. Again, by using the don't care also, same is given. We have to implement this three variable function using 4:1 mux. If you observe the second table, which is a folding technique, 7 is there in the don't care, so which is not encircled. So if you don't consider 7, then you have to connect it to the A dash. If you consider 7, connect it to the VCC. And these are the questions for you. You can implement this by using 4:1 mux. What are the applications of the multiplexer? Data routing, data busing. During the bus also, in case of microcontroller, microprocessor, or maybe for designing a embedded system, various slaves has to be transmit the data on the they has to transmit the data to the master, or maybe some kind of the acknowledgement they want to send. Then a single bus is there. If a single bus is there, then a multiplexing can be used. Switch setting comparator, multiplexer as a function generator, parallel to serial converter, cable TV signal distribution, telephone network, and sharing printer or resources. So these are the applications of the multiplexers. So in this lecture we have discussed about what is a multiplexer, its internal structure, how the multiplexing takes place with the help of one animated video we have studied, then multiplexer tree, and how to implement a combinational circuit using multiplexers. We have also studied about the folding technique and the applications of the MUX. Thank you.